Hey, welcome back to my channel. I am showing you guys how I did my twist out, which is something that I've never done before. This is my first time and I actually love it. But of course, you know, I'm gonna start with my makeup because that's just what I do. I love makeup. So I started with a bare face and created my eyebrows because mine are so faint, like they're so thin, they're barely there. So I basically just create the ones that I feel fits my face. I've been doing it for a long time, so yeah. So I'm using a pencil and then I'll use the powder later on to pretty much clean up everything. But here I'm using the LA Pro Concealer, which I got from my local beauty supply store. The color I have is creamy beige, and I'm using it as a base for my eyeshadow as well. So that's why I apply so much product at the bottom, and then at the top I would use medium beige. But for some reason it did not record, but yeah, I use the medium beige at the top, and this helps to just pretty much shape the eyebrow and make it pop more. So on the left bottom is the first eyeshadow I used before I went in with the dark brown. You know, I'm making this soft smoky eye, which is pretty much an everyday look. It's not anything too dramatic. So I'm just going over that first color, the first shade, and I'm going over it with a darker shade, but just focusing on the outer part of my eye. And then I went in with the liquid eyeliner to create a wing. Now the wing you can make as dramatic as you want or as soft as you want. So here I'm just doing a little light wing. Just, you know, just something quick. You know, I'm not going anywhere. So just put a little something together. You do have to have a steady hand in order to create a wing and to use the liquid eyeliner. So once I'm done with my eyes, I am going to use, you know, prime my face, and I use baby skin. I got that from CVS, I believe. So I apply that all over my face to pretty much fill in all my pores and to help with the application of the foundation. So once I have that all blended in, I'm going in with my liquid foundation, and I actually use two different shades, two different brands. And I know you're wondering like why it looks so dark on my face, and that's because my face is like the lightest part of my body. Like honestly, my face doesn't get any sun because I wear so much makeup. So I'm like Casper the ghost in the face. But yeah, so I'm trying to make my face match my body. So, you know, I go a little darker, not too extreme, but I do use a darker foundation than the color of my face. But to help it out, you know, I use the Pro Concealer again as a highlight. I highlight all my areas up under the eye, the bridge of my nose, the forehead, and then the chin. So with this on top of my contour, it does give my face like a smaller appearance, especially the nose. I call it the Michael Jackson nose. But you know, I top that with translucent powder, and this is by Airspun. I did get this from my local drugstore. I think it was like $13. So I use Airspun to pretty much help with the shiny parts of my face, which is normally like between my eyebrows, my forehead, and the sides of my nose. So I'm going to let that sit for a little bit and go in and contour with the contouring palette. Yeah, so this is the part where I said, you know, helps to give you that that slimness if you desire. So I'm pretty much going to go on the outer parts of my nose, the outer part of my forehead, and the upper part of my cheek to make it appear, you know, slimmer, smaller, and to, you know, bring that color back in as much as possible. So once I have all that blended out, I mean, it'll still be there, like you'll still see the lines down the nose, but it depends, like, what lighting you're in and stuff. It doesn't look too bad on camera, but I'm just gonna go ahead and blend it in as much as possible without taking it all, you know, fully away. And I like to go in, you know, so it meets with my eyebrow. So then once I have all that, you know, going, I'm gonna use my powder palette. This is a powder foundation, and this helps to pretty much make everything not one tone, but to help tone everything out, like the setting powder, so it doesn't look so yellow. I'm gonna go in and make it look more neutral. And this is my go-to. Like, I have to highlight my nose and my cheeks. So it's like a little bronzer. I use that. It's a liquid. And then I use my fan brush to go ahead and blend everything in. Yep, it helps you to have that glow, girl. Now here's the powder I was speaking of. So I'm going in, and whatever I touched with my brush, I'm just gonna go ahead and clean it up and make sure that my brows are still intact and nice and clean. And this part, I'm using a spoolie, and I'm going the opposite way. Like, I'm bringing it towards the inner part of my nose. That helps to give you that ombre look for the eyebrows. And of course, you can't apply makeup without applying lashes. So I'm using some lashes. These are actually purchased from my cousin, Fly Diamond. Go check her out. It's not too dramatic. Like I said, I'm not doing anything too dramatic tonight. Just a, you know, a little something to go with my new natural hairstyle that I'm gonna try out. I am used to wearing sew-ins and closures and wigs and things like that, so I'm gonna try to give myself a break. So here I was applying the setting spray, so it helps to keep your makeup lasting longer. And now I'm doing my lips with a brown pencil, just outlining my lips. And then I'm gonna use a nude lipstick, so pretty much like giving my lips an ombre. So I didn't want it just all pink, and I didn't want just all brown, so I did a little mixture of both. And the lip gloss that I'm using, I actually got from a local beauty supply store too, along with my NYX lingerie. So here we are. We're getting to the hair part. My hair is clean. I washed it the night before, conditioned it, and I had to make a run, so I just put the two braids in it. I did use a little bit of product to pretty much lay it down, but overall it's clean. And because you can see, like, my edges are very thin, and again, that's from me wearing so much of the weave and, you know, all the tension and stuff on my edges. The edges is very, very, very like sensitive. And the last person that did my hair, you know, they were not too cautious of where they laid the glue with the closure. So yeah, that's what happened there. I mean, it's hair, it'll grow back, but still. So here I am parting my hair with a red tail comb. I did spray some leave-in conditioner. I'm gonna put all the products that I use at the bottom, but I am parting my hair with a rat tail comb. I'm starting in the back here. I'm just putting the rest of the hair up into a ponytail, you know, out of the way. And I'm gonna, you know, do it section by section. So here I'm, you know, detangling and using the leave-in conditioner. And then the other products that I'm using, which would be the gel. Here's the Luster's Pink. That is a curling cream. And I'm just gonna part it and start twisting. So, you know, like I said, this is the first time I've ever done coil twists or two-strand twists on my natural hair. This right here, everybody's go-to gel. But this is, you know, just something that I want to try out for a little bit and, you know, just see how I like it. So I'm parting and detangling at the same time and making sure I got enough moisture on each strand. And I'm twisting. So as I'm twisting, I'm also rolling the hair. So it's like a roll, twist, all the way down to the end. And then I'm gonna twirl the end. And I'm not gonna use any rubber bands or anything. I'm just gonna twirl the ends with my finger, you know, so that it stays. I mean, so far so good. It's kind of small. I guess I wanted it a little chunkier. So I guess that's why, you know, later in the video, you'll see that I did make bigger parts, because like I said, this is my first time, so it's not going to be as perfect. I did find out what I did wrong, you know, the error, but you know, next time I try it, it should turn out better. So yeah, that part, I started twisting it, but I was twisting it the opposite way. So I just combed it out and just went back in and started retwisting. And it's kind of hard, like, not having a double mirror or you're not able to see how you parted the hair, but it wasn't a big deal to me because nobody's gonna see the part once the strands are pulled apart. So I mean, I just parted it for the purposes of, you know, keeping two strands, but it wasn't a big deal. I actually could have just grabbed the hair and just started twisting away, but I'm kind of a perfectionist when it comes to things like this. So I did not record the entire part of me twisting it. I started back recording once I get towards the front, because I'm pretty much, you know, still doing the same thing. Taking the hair a section at a time, spraying a detangling spray, putting the curling cream on there, the gel. And I use another product too. Like I said, I'm gonna list everything. Well, everything is listed and the description box. Most of the product I got from the local beauty supply store, except for one of them, I got from Walmart. And this is the product that I decided to add at the last minute. I want as much moisture as possible, especially if I plan to just wear my natural hair, you know, without touching it or, you know, doing too much to it. I don't want it to be out and dry. And I stay in Detroit, so it's pretty cold. And during the cold months, everything dries out, your skin, your hair. So, you know, it's good to just drink plenty of water and use some moisturizing products for your hair. Especially us African American people, you know. That's just how it is. But now you have more detail of how big my parts are. So it's almost like 5 braids to a row. And then the white stuff, I guess it's because I applied too much of the product. But as you can see, if you notice, I am just, you know, taking the excess stuff off and just, you know, putting it on my hair. No need for it to go to waste. But it turned out okay. Once it dried, you're not gonna see any of the white stuff. I mean, it pretty much just soaks up, I guess. It's not a chemical, so it can't hurt anything. And then most of the products that I'm using, it has, you know, all natural ingredients. Shea butter, coconut oil, black castor, you know, things like that. One of them may have had mango in it, and it helps my hair smell so good. Like, it smells really good, really clean and fruity. So during the recording, you know, I did not record the entire time that it took me to twist, but I actually completed this part. It was probably like 30 minutes. If I had done smaller parts, I'm sure it would have took me a lot longer, but just a half hour to do. You know, the jumbo 2-strand twist. And I didn't want to do anything too crazy, especially with this being my first time. And, you know, spending a lot of time twisting my hair and then just don't like the outcome. But since I do like it, you know, each time I can get better with it faster and make it last longer, you know, with the smaller twist. I wasn't sure if like a middle part or a side part mattered, but because I wanted a side part, I kind of, you know, parted it on the side and twisted the ones at the top down, and then the ones on the other side, I twisted them the opposite way, you know, just in case once I took the twist out, I was not able to part it, it would already be there. And that was the look I was going for. So I just went on ahead and did the side part before twisting the hair. to my last braid. So by the time I made it to the top on the last braid, the back was pretty much drying. I know, like I said, it looked like I put way too much product in it. So when I got ready to take the twist out, I mean, the twists were there, but maybe if I had put less product in it or just let it sit overnight, I'm sure the curls would have been even more popping once I untwisted them. But, you know, the back was drying while I worked on the front, so I was ready to untwist them. And this is what I used for the little bit of edges I had left. I actually like it. I use this product on my daughter. Again, it's another natural product, good for African Americans. And it helps, like, to keep her hair down, whether she's getting ponytails or braids. And it's not anything harsh, but it keeps the hair in place. So I went on ahead and tried to do what I could with my edges. And I am all done with this. And I did not do the video of me taking the twists apart, because I mean, pretty simple. You just unravel what you did and pretty much spread it to your desire. So this is the coil two strand twist, and then here I am with the twist out. I really hope you guys enjoyed my video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'm gonna have some more juice for you in my next video. Thank you for watching.